Very good evening to each and every one of you present here for this course. And welcome to the Collaborative Learning Cafe. Welcome to yet another day with the Collaborative Learning Cafe. And I'm privileged to introduce you to our Father Pratap, who is our faculty for the Konkani Online Workshop. And well, Father has a long list of achievements, but that I can tell you a lot about, but he's also quite particular about time, which is very precious for him, and he's definitely eager to start off the course. So in a capsule, here is a gist of the person that Father Pratap Naik is. MPhil and PhD in linguistics at the Pune University. He has to his credit a beautiful list of publications. He has to his credit about 34 books. Those consist of Konkani plays, poems, devotional songs, Konkani nursery rhymes. He also has about, let me mention that some of his famous books are the ones famous with the children, that is Hasun Khelon Ashikat, very well famous amongst the youngsters. He also has to his credit about 50 research articles in many various Konkani journals, and he's written about 200 poems. He's well known over the airwaves. He's given us a lot of radio talks, poetry recitation, interviews, panel discussions also at All India Radio Panaji. And as far as visuals are concerned, he has given a lot of talks, interviews, participated in discussions, not just on Doordarshan, but on various other TV channels. Audio cassettes and DVDs, of course, for those who know him well, there are various famous cassettes that he's come with. The famous among them being Hasun Khelon Gauya. And he's also, you can hear his voice over for the Konkani Basic course, a CD that is at TSKK. He has conducted many academic activities for not just teachers, but for also graduate and postgraduate students. He's organized seminars, workshops for teachers and students, taken part in various conferences. And to talk about his awards, there are four prominent ones. One is the Devo Award 2004. The 2008 is the Bruno Eduardo Souza Yadostik Sanman. In 2008, it was awarded to him. The Shennoi Goimbap Puraskar from Vavradanso Isht Konkani Weekly. This was in 2009, and in 2011, he was awarded the Dalgado Sahitya Puraskar from Dalgado Konkani Academy, Goa. He is also has a life membership of various associations like the Konkani Bhasha Mandal, the Indian Linguistic Association, and many other associations. Prominent is also the editor of SOTH, that is the TSKK Research Bulletin. And as far as the social service is concerned, he's been very helpful towards students, especially the ones who come from financially poor backgrounds. He's helped a lot of students to achieve their goals, to complete their studies. And that is the person that Father Pratap is. And we are very privileged to have him here in our midst as to conduct the Konkani course for all of us. Oh, also a small request that the everyone who's joining in, kindly keep your videos switched off so that just for the convenience of the rest of the participants, just requesting all the other members to keep your videos switched off. And over to Father Pratap. Father, you can take over.
Deobari sans deo, that means good evening. We shall begin by invoking God's blessing. Kindly close your eyes, bow your head, and pray to God in your own way. I, being a Catholic and Jesuit priest, I shall pray my way. Our loving Heavenly Abba Father, you have given the unique gift of speaking a language and learning new languages to human beings. Send down your spirit upon us, upon every participant of this course. Enlighten their minds and help me to teach them effectively. This prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. Saint Ignatius, pray for us. This year is a special year for us Jesuits because we celebrate the Jubilee year of Ignatius Loyola, our founder. It is 500 years since his conversion, and the Jubilee year began on 20th May 2021 and it ends next year on 31st July on the feast day of Saint Ignatius Loyola. So as a part of the Ignatian Jubilee year, Goa province is organizing a number of online talks, workshops, courses. And this is the first one. I have stopped teaching Konkani to beginners for many years. I now spend my time only with the scholars and already those who know Konkani. But this being an Ignatian year, at the request of Father Mervyn and Dr. Frederick Norona, my friend, I consented. So that is enough. The name of the course is Introduction to Konkani. It is an introduction. Remember, it is not a full-fledged Konkani course. To do a full-fledged Konkani course, you have to spend minimum 6 months full time with me or with somebody. That is not possible for you and for me also. So this course is only of 15 hours from 6 to 16, that is from today till 16th of June. Okay, this is the resource person. I stay at Loyola Hall, Miramar, Goa, India. All the technical assistance given and the coordinator is Mr. Savio Dias, Belgavi, Karnataka. And I thank him right now because without him, I won't be able to do anything here because I'm a novice as far as online course is concerned. This is my first experience. I always teach offline and face to face. Okay, who will benefit from this course? Who will be the beneficiaries? First, those who are in the age group of 20 to 40, maximum 50. I say this because younger you are, your capacity to learn a new language is greater. It does not mean you cannot learn a new language after 50. No, I'm not saying that. But younger people learn faster. Two, those who do not know Konkani or know very little of it. This course is meant for these people, this group, those who do not know Konkani at all, or they know very little of it. And if you know Konkani, this course will not benefit you that much. So you are free to leave at any time because it is meant for this group. Now, what are the objectives of this course? As far as I am concerned, the first objective is to learn the basic structure of standard Konkani using the Roman alphabet. Basic structure. I'm teaching you the basic minimum structure of standard Konkani. Now you might wonder, what is the standard Konkani? Because there are so many Konkani dialects are there. So standard Konkani, I have evolved with the help of these Jesuit dictionaries of 16th and 17th century, because I know also old Konkani, with the grammar Arte da Lingua Canari of Father Thomas Stevens, a Jesuit who lived in 16th, 17th century. And Monsignor Sebastião Delgado, his Konkani Portuguese and Portuguese Konkani dictionary, which were written at the end of 19th century. And this one was written beginning of 20th century. So based on this and the church in Goa through Roman script promoted Konkani. So combining all these and even other dialects, I have created a standard Konkani, which I speak wherever I go. I write in that. I don't change my language according to the place. No, same Konkani I use along the coastal line of India. The second objective is to learn the standard pronunciation of Konkani words, because the same word has different pronunciation. So I'm going to teach you the standard pronunciation. Third objective, to learn minimum 700 to 800 basic Konkani words and expressions. If you learn this much, it will be a great thing, because then at least you will understand a basic Konkani. At least you will know certain basic Konkani sentences. Fourth, to generate a number of simple sentences with the help of this basic structure which I'm going to teach you, you will be able to generate a number of sentences, any number of simple sentences. And the fifth one, to learn to read Konkani with the help of the modified orthography of Roman alphabet. Orthography means writing system. Konkani is written mainly now in three alphabet: Roman, Devanagari, and Kannada. And all these three I know, I read, write, and teach in all these three scripts. But none of them are adequate for a beginner to learn Konkani, because they write one thing and they pronounce something else, like English. So with the help of diacritical marks, I have evolved a system. One letter, one pronunciation. So without knowing the meaning, you will be able to read, just like Latin. M-A-T-E-R, mater in Latin. That means mother. Pater, P-A-T-E-R, pater in Latin means father. Similarly, you will learn, today itself you will see, you can read Konkani provided you learn those symbols. Now, what are the tools to achieve these objectives? The first tool is online classes. There is no attendance taken. There is no syllabus. There are no exams. But let me remind you, if you miss a class, you won't be able to understand what is said in the previous class. Therefore, you have to decide whether to attend or not to attend. And I'm not going to repeat what I said yesterday. I will have a certain repetition, but just because a few students missed a class, I'm not going to repeat, because there is no time, because this is a very, very short course. Then what are the other material which are available for you? Konkani Bas, there are 13 videos of mine. They are on the CCR TV Goa YouTube. You just type on YouTube CCR TV, you subscribe to it. It is free, totally free. You go to their playlist and you find all these following videos there. Learning Konkani, there are 21 videos of mine, but the explanation there is in Konkani and little bit in English. Burgyale Angan, that means courtyard of children, there are 13 videos of children's songs, simple children's songs are available. Bhakti Lara, these are non-denominational Konkani songs, 26 videos are there. And Shimpiantli Motiyang is thought for the day. So far, 144 videos are on YouTube. Every week, CCR TV hosts two more. So this will go on. We have already recorded 200 videos, but on the YouTube, 144 are available. So these are the tools. And then another important tool is my colleague, Father Matthew Almeida, who is no more, who wrote this book, Rumi Lippi and Konkani Course in Roman Script. This book, you can buy it. You can ask Frederick Norona to make it available, and he can do it that. So, but the orthography used in this book and mine are different. There is difference, but still, this book will help you a great lot, because all the explanation, grammar, there is a dictionary, there is meaning, everything in English. So this is the one book which you can later on refer. And the last tool is self-motivation and self-study. Everything depends on you. It doesn't depend on me. I will do my part to the best of my ability. Rest is with you. So with this short introduction, let us begin. The medium of instruction here would be English. Everything I'll be explaining in English. So we shall begin now with Konkani vowels. Konkani vowels, how the name Konkani is written, K-O-N-K-N-N-I, and not the traditional one, K-O-N-K-A-N-I. If you write that way, our people here in Goa say Konkani, especially the Catholics say Konkani. It is not Konkani, it is Konkani. Our language is Konkani. Okay, Konkani vowels. We have two types of vowels in Konkani. First, oral vowels. What do I mean by oral vowels? When you pronounce them, the air comes from the mouth, and those are called oral vowels. And second are nasal vowels. Air comes both from the nose and from the mouth. So we have these two types of vowels, Konkani. Now, oral vowels, we have 8 oral vowels. I've given here the symbol letter. Example, this is Konkani, the meaning in English. Then example in Konkani, meaning in English, and how this vowel has to be pronounced. Some help for you from English. Now, the first vowel is A. If you know Devanagari script, that means Marathi or Hindi, if you know, this is pronounced like A. And the example is Aso. Let me repeat. Aso. A, so, Aso. Meaning like this. Second example, Ghar. 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 House. And this symbol to be pronounced as you pronounce in English, around. Around. I have underlined letter A. What is the pronunciation of this underlined A? That is A. Something, I don't say exact, but very close to that. The second vowel is letter A, but its pronunciation is A. A. Az, az, az means today. Second example, kal, K-A-K-A, and this L means L, kal. Yesterday. How do you say father? This pronunciation of this A is equal to this. So one letter, one pronunciation. This you cannot pronounce any other way except as. Same way, kal. You cannot say kal, call, no, kal. Same way, this one, you cannot say any other way, aso. And this one, ghar. Next vowel is e. Short or long, I shall explain to you. K-I-double-D. Keed. Keed. Now, in this word, there is one vowel. Therefore, it's called monosyllabic word. When there is only one vowel, in Konkani, the pronunciation is rather long. It is not kid. It is keed. Keed. Meaning worm. But here, K-I-double-D-I, kiddy. Because there are two vowels, one vowel here and one vowel here. Therefore, it is called polysyllabic word. Therefore, pronunciation is short. Kid, but kiddy. Worms. How do you pronounce in the wind that I pronunciation is equal to this? Is my speed is too fast for you?
Father, if I'm a doubt, can I ask you?
No, questions we will keep out. I'm just asking, is my speed is too fast for you?
It's good, Father.
Very good. I think it is fine.
Okay. Questions we will keep at the end. Otherwise, we will be all the time busy with questions and nothing we will learn today.
Okay, Father.
Yeah. There are last 15 minutes, you have questions and which could be extended, which Savio will be coordinating. Next vowel is U. Letter U, but pronunciation is U. Maybe long, maybe short. This one. U's. Now there is one vowel. Therefore, the rule in Konkani, when there is one vowel, the pronunciation is long. U's and not us. You cannot say us. That is in English you can say us. You are not reading now English. Remember, you are reading Konkani. And in Konkani, one letter, one pronunciation in this orthography of mine. Woos, sugar cane. Take this word. S-U-T-A-R. Sutar. Sutar. Here there are two vowels. One and two. Therefore, it is short. It is not sutar. No. Sutar. Carpenter. And how do you say put? How do you pronounce this U in put? Same pronunciation is of this vowel, U. Next vowel, look at carefully. E and with a circumflex, there is a symbol, inverted V, that is called circumflex. It is a closed vowel, pair, 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 guava tree. This one, maize, maize. Maze, count. What is the pronunciation of this letter E in a day? Something like that. This one. Closed one. E. And this one down, A. This is A and this is A. Pear. This is pear. Guava tree. And this is pear. Those who know Konkani, at once by hearing this sound, they know pear means guava tree and pear means guava fruit. Pear. This one. Maize. Look at the difference between maize and maize. Maize means count and maize means table. The pronunciation is in rat. How do you pronounce this A in rat? That is the pronunciation of this. So these two sounds you have to distinguish. And for many language speakers in their respective language, if they don't have this distinction, their tendency would be either to pronounce all words this way or all words this way. No? Therefore, in Konkani, there's a difference between A and A. Let me repeat once again. A, pear, 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 guava tree, maize, maize, count, and this is a, pear, pear, guava fruit, maize, maize, table. Now we shall proceed. This letter O with the circumflex. This is O, closed sound, O. Look at here, C, H, and this O and R, chor. This is chor, thief. Another example, bore, bore, jujube tree. Now, those who do not know jujube tree, very difficult to me explain in the coastal line here in India. We have that tree and which you get these fruits now in summer, now they are over. So that tree is called bore. Now how to pronounce this O? How do you say go? Closed one, no? This O is closed. It is not go. Go. So something, this pronunciation is something like this, O. And next one, O. O, open, chor. Chor versus chor. Thief, thieves. So if you want to say thieves, you must say chor. And if you want to say thief, you must say chor. Similarly here, bor. This is bor, jujube tree. But bor is the jujube fruit. How do you pronounce this word? Toss. This pronunciation of this O is here. So let me repeat once again this one. This is O, chor, bor. And this is O, chor, bor. So we have learnt so far. We will come for repetition. Don't worry. Don't worry. And all this matter will be available to you on a cloud, which Savio will make it available. We have learnt 8 oral vowels of Konkani. And now it comes the difficult part. Now we have nasal vowels, 8. Equivalent to these 8 oral vowels, we have 8 nasal vowels. No other language in India has got so many vowels like this. I mean, of course, there is one language called Urrao or Kuduk. And my studies goes from Kuduk language or Urrao language. These nasal vowels we acquired because the original natives of Goa are Kuduk people, Urrao people who settled down in Goa. And in that language, these nasal sounds are found. They have oral vowels and they have nasal vowels. Sanskrit doesn't have so many nasal vowels. English doesn't have. French has got few. Marathi has few. Hindi, hardly any. But Konkani has got 8 oral vowels and 8 nasal vowels. Now this one. This is N. This is not an. This N nasalizes this vowel. This is N. Example, zain, 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 where, thain, thain. This Y to be pronounced like y consistently. Y in Konkani is the sound is y, and this N nasalizes the previous vowel. So thain means there. Let me repeat. A, zain, excuse me. Thain. Next vowel. A. It is written in two ways. A, N, A, or A, M, A. Pronunciation is same, but writing, we have two options. The first option is used here. Ankdo. Ankdo. Number. When the nasalization comes at the beginning of a word or middle of the word, N is used. Here is the beginning. This should be ankdo. Ankdo. Number. And here the nasalization comes at the end of the word. So it is gara. It is not garam. No, gara. 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 Chop. Houses. Let me repeat. A. Ankado. Gara. Then. E. Both these are E. Inter, inter, the beginning of a word, N is used to nasalize this vowel. Inter means funeral. We got this word from Portuguese. That doesn't matter. It has become part of Konkani now. Funeral. Here, It comes at the end. Tantim. You cannot pronounce as tantim. No. Tantim. Ta. Here there are two nasalization. T-A-N. Ta. Ta. Tim. Tantim. Egg. Let me repeat. E. Inter. Tantim. Next. Undir. This UN become and DIR become dir. Undir. Rat. Yeah. Asum. You cannot pronounce asum. No. A is a. A s as. A s u asu. And this M added become asu. Let it be. Let me repeat. Undir. Asu. A. Closed one. A. You know this. E with the circumflex means closed one. A. Pained. 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 Oil cake. After extracting oil, either from coconut or from any other seeds, whatever remains is called oil cake. In Konkani, we say pained. Another example. Daint. Daint. Stem. Stem of a fruit or a flower which joins the branch. From the branch, between the branch and the flower or the fruit, there is a small portion that is called stem or daint. Let me repeat. A. Pained. Pained. Daint. Daint. If you remove this circumflex, it becomes dant. Means stems. See, meaning changes. Pronunciation changes. If you remove this circumflex, it becomes panned. Panned it becomes. So, the symbols are very important. And the pronunciation to be learnt correctly. Then, this is open. And tanko. This N nasalizes this open vowel. Tanko. Tanko. Support. Next example. Kale. Kale. It is not kalem. Kale. Banana. Let me repeat. And tanko kale. And this one, pained daint. Tanko kale. And the last set is om. Om. Kombi. Kombi. Hen. I have consistently used N in the medial position. This N nasalizes this O. Those who know, some of you know Konkani, they may say, well, no, but we use M. I know. But there is no consistency in our writing. So I have written consistently here in the initial position or medial position. To nasalize the vowel, use N. And at the end of the word, use M. So this is kombi, means hen. Another example, fond. Fond means grave. In the cemetery, we have the graves. Those are the grave. And you remove the circumflex, it becomes fond, plural, graves. But this is fond, one. The open sound. Aw. This is also aw. Three symbols are there for the open sound. Here, combo. See, this is kombi, but this is combo. Open. You cannot say combo, combo. No. Those who know Marathi, they pronounce combo. No, in Konkani, combo. And this is kombi, rooster. And this one, karton, karton. It is not karton, karton. I would have done. And I put in a bracket, M means masculine. Who can say this? A man or a boy can say karton. What woman will say? That I will teach you later on. Let's not mix it up here now. This is only for a, only a man or a boy could say this. Karton. I would have done. In English, of course, there is no such distinction. Whether it's a man, woman, girl, anybody speaks, they say, I would have done. But in Konkani, there is a difference when a man or a boy speak and when a girl or a woman speak. And see here the last example, Goi. Goi means Goa. What is called Goa in English? In Konkani we say Goi. And this spelling I propose with great difficulty. Now this is accepted. Otherwise we used to write differently and pronounce something. No. Now this means Goi, means Goa. Or any word which is generated using this, then we use this spelling. What is a going car? We use this spelling, going. So now we have learnt 8 oral vowels and 8 nasal vowels. Konkani has 8 oral vowels and 8 nasal vowels. This I have explained, but I have put down in writing. In monosyllabic words, that means in a word there is one vowel, the vowels a, a, e and u are slightly longer than polysyllabic words. Example, this one, sat. You cannot say sat. It not sat, sat, because there is one vowel a, therefore it is sat. Look at its plural, sata. It is not sata. No, sata, because there are two vowels, naturally then the pronunciation becomes shorter. Sat, sata. I should have given here the meaning of it. I have not given right now. Let me give you. That's the meaning, sat. Here I will give. That means truth. And sata is its plural. Ran, ran. I have not given the meaning. Let me give. Ran means forest. Ran. Longer, because there is only one vowel. Rana, short, forest. All the English, the meaning I've given in square brackets. Anything I write in English, usually I give in a square brackets. So forest, ran, rana. Next example, let us take these. These means day. These, not this. These, one vowel, therefore the pronunciation is long. These, but these are. Disa means from this word these, we'll say at day. You want to say come at day, not at night. Then we say disa, short. Next example, put. Put means sun. Now in English it is put. We are not reading English now. We are reading Konkani using modified Roman alphabet. Put, one vowel, therefore it is long. Put, but puta. Puta means, oh my son. You want to call your son, we say puta. Then it is short. So we have learnt up to now. Let me repeat. Oh, just recapitulate. 8 oral vowels, long and short also. This is long, keed, kiddy, but we don't show the difference because the rule is very obvious and clear. One vowel, always long. More than one vowel, it is short. Therefore, we don't show in Roman script. In Devanagari script, they show. They use two symbols. Kannada script uses two symbols. Roman script, absolutely, there is no need. So we learned 8 oral vowels. Let me repeat. A, A, E, U, A, A, O, O. These are the oral vowels and corresponding nasal vowels. A, A, E, U, A, A, O, O. Very symmetrical in Konkani. 8 oral vowels, 8 nasal vowels. 16 vowels we have in Konkani. I mean, each language has its own peculiarity. English has its own. Most of the time, I ask English teachers, how many vowels are there in English? They tell me 5. I ask them, which are those? A, E, I, O, U. I tell them, no, those are vowel symbols. A, E, I, O, U are not vowels. They are vowel symbols. There are many more vowels in English, but I have not come to teach you English. You take Oxford or Cambridge dictionary and you will see how many vowels are there in English. So, let us continue. In Konkani, we have A and O are closed and slightly longer vowels. This I have explained to you. Then A and O, which are open and short vowels. This and this, they are closed vowels and they are slightly longer. And this are open vowels and they are short vowels. Now, what I had explained, I have once again given here. Konkani has 8 nasal vowels corresponding to the 8 oral vowels. Nasalization is shown by N or M or by this symbol. This is called til, T-I-L, til. Portuguese uses frequently this symbol, til. I have used in Konkani only in one place, goi. Elsewhere, we are managing with either with N or M. N is used, explained already here. Let me repeat. When a vowel in the initial or middle position of a word to be nasalized, we use N. For example, ambo. See here. This is the initial position, A. Without this N, this becomes abo. But when you put N, it becomes ambo, meaning mango. Medial position, bank. Don't pronounce like bank, that is English. Bank, constantly you have to remind yourself, you are reading Konkani and get the symbol. See, B means ba, B-A, ba, B-A-N, ba. K means k, so bank, bench. When a vowel at the end of the word to be nasalized, we use M. For example, hem, H-E-M, not hem, it is hem. What is the meaning? This, but it is NT means neuter gender. I will come to this point. When I teach you nouns, in Konkani has 3 gender system, masculine, feminine, and neuter. English doesn't have this thing. English now practically everything is neuter gender, or for human beings it is masculine and feminine. For everything else it is neuter. Marathi has this 3 gender system. Now, only to write the word goi and words derived from it such as going car, going so, etc., we use this teal symbol. Only for this word, going. Going car. Going so. Or going chi. There only we use. Otherwise, we will use end and am. So, with this, the vowels, Konkani vowels, 8 oral vowels, 8 nasal vowels, and their respective symbols I have introduced you, which you have to look at them again and again, try to practice as much you can, and then you will learn it. It takes time. So don't worry, you will learn it. So we have learned the vowels of Konkani. 16 vowels we have learned. Now we have to learn consonants. Have to go, Sabio, to open the file.
Minimize the Google Meet.
Okay. Straight I can take the file only?
Just check
whether...
Yeah, it is visible.
Okay. Can you see now?
Yes, Father.
Okay, good. Now we have learned the vowels. Now let us do certain exercises. Exercises are very important. Repetition is very important. So here there are exercises. In the following paradigms, this is called paradigm. All this chart is called paradigms. You will learn the contrast of vowel. There is a contrast between two vowels. Difference. What are those contrasts? You will learn. Carefully look at the paradigm below, this paradigm. Concentrate on the contrast in pronunciation within each pair of words in the paradigm and repeat the words so as to bring out the contrast. See, oral vowels, nasal vowels, two compartments. Here, letter, symbol, word and word Konkani and meaning in English. Same way here, letter is given and the word in Konkani are given and meaning is given. Now, we have learnt already the pronunciation of this der. You cannot pronounce anything else except this. Der means rate of any item. Der, which has got many more other meanings, I have given only one meaning, rate. Der. And look at here, this is dant, worm. This is not dant. Those who know Konkani Devanagari script, they will say dant. If you write to dant, it has to be written differently. How? I shall teach you later on. But in the standard Konkani, we don't say dant, the worm in your stomach, dant. Der, dant. So contrast between oral vowel, nasal vowel. One more example. Khat, stain on your clothes. Something falls on your clothes, then you get that stain. Khat. And here, khant. What is the difference between this and this? It is nasalized using N because it is in the medial position. Khat versus khant. Grief, sorrow. Next one. This letter, A. So henceforth, we should not say A. No. In Konkani, this is A. This is A. At least I am going to use consistently A in Konkani. But in English, I will say A. But here, this is A. Nath. Granddaughter. and this is anant. They are not there. Next example, bai means sister. It could be your elder sister, it could be younger sister, or to any lady with respect you address her bai. Oh, I made a mistake here. Bai. See, this is bai and this is bai. Well, see that difference in meaning. Just you add letter N, it nasalizes this vowel A and it becomes bai. Bai, bai. Nath, nant. Next one. Para, O child. If you want to call a child, you say para. And this is a para. It is not param, para. Children. Para, open. This is open. You cannot say para. No, para. And you cannot say this para. No, para. Open. Para. Para. Letter E. Cheek. It not chic. Cheek. Study. Cheek. Study. And this is E. Chink. Sneeze. Many Konkani speakers, instead of saying this, they say this. Chink. They don't make the distinction. No, you have to make a distinction between chic means study and chink means sneeze. You cannot say Konkani chinkta. No, Konkani shikta. I study Konkani. Konkani shikta. Ani aam shinkta. I sneezed. You will learn this in a course. Next, T, chi, and see e, teen means they, neuter plural. This is neuter plural. T versus teen. It is not tim. It is this M nasalizing the vowel E. Teen. T versus teen. Oot. Oot. Rise. You are sleeping and you have to now rise. Oot. And this one, oont. Oont. Camel. Oont. Next example, suit. Suit. The one meaning is discount. It has got other meanings. Don't worry, but I have given the meaning discount. Suit, discount. And soont, dried ginger, which are used in India to prepare various dishes. Sometimes they use the dried ginger, one of the spices. This is already, you know, A, close, A. Pedi. Pedi. Hilsa fishes. Now you may wonder, what is this Hilsa fishes? Very difficult for me to show. You have to come with me to Panji market. And there, these are available. Very poor man's fish, but now it is still costly. Pedi, a type of fish which has got many bones. So star hotels don't use such fishes. These are used by common person like me. We have to eat this fish now in Goa. A, this is A and this is A. Pendi. Pendi means bunches of fruit, any fruit like coconut or mango, bunches, there should be bunches, pendi, bunches of fruit. This is pedi and this is pendi. A. Next, a. This is a and this is a. Pat. Wooden box. Pat. And this is a. Pant. Trousers. Look at the Konkani spelling of pant. Pant. Meaning trousers. Another example for this, te means they, masculine, plural, not feminine, plural, masculine, plural, te, and this is te.
Father, sorry to interrupt, you've missed fenugreek and you.
One example, yeah, thank you, yes, the methi. It is not methi, it is close, methi. Fenugreek is also another spices it use. It is bitter. Those who got diabetes, they take the powder of that, methi. And this is mendi. Oh, here I made a mistake. I have to put this symbol. Mendi means ewe, the female sheep, ewe. Mendi, methi. Mendi. A. So I was here. Ta means they, but masculine plural. Now you might wonder what is feminine plural. Don't worry. When I will teach you plural pronouns, you will learn all this. All this will, most of these example words will be repeated in another context. And this is ta. It cannot say tem. No. Ta. Means it. This symbol O. Ford. So it has got two meanings. I given the both meaning. Piece of a fruit. Let's say piece. Ford. Or it also means a boil, which you get on your body. Ford. And this is phoned. Already this example had come earlier. Ford versus phoned. This one N nasalizes the previous vowel and the closed vowel. Ford, phoned. Kobi, cabbage. Kobi. And without this symbol circumflex, it become Kobi. Somebody can say Kobi, but here the way I've written, you cannot pronounce any other way. None of these words, they have got only one pronunciation, finished. Doesn't matter who reads and who writes, if it's written this way, the learner has absolutely no difficulty to read Konkani. To read Konkani in this system, to tell my friend Frederick, will be drinking Feni. Some people love to drink Feni. And they enjoy it. Same way this one. Once you learn the art of these symbols, you can read any word of Konkani written with this system. You may not know the meaning which you have to learn, but reading is 100% should be correct. Kobi, cabbage. And this is kombi. This word we have learned. See the difference between kobi and kombi. N. Kobi, kombi. And the last one, O. This is O and this is O. Cord, leprosy. And this is O, cond, pond with the water, pond. And this one, God, jaggery, Indian sugar made of sugar cane. God. And this one, Gondo, tuft of a clothes of a, especially girls or women like to, they have this for their dresses, tuft, Gondo. And another, last example I given, Goi, it's not going, Goi, Goa. So we have learned what contrast we have learned, oral vowels versus nasal vowels.
Father, we have got 20 minutes left.
Beg pardon?
We have got 20 minutes left.
Yes. Now I will reserve for question and answers. You,
if anybody has any questions, can raise their hands and unmute.
Question should be based on what I have taught you today. On that.
Can we have questions?
Should be pointed. What I have taught you today, either for pronunciation or meaning or spelling, you have certain doubts, you may ask.
You all can even type the questions in the chat box so that we'll read it out to Father and Father will answer those questions.
Yes,
too.
I will answer. Yes.
The script that you are teaching.
Yes.
Is this used in all the publications?
No. You know, script is very orthodox. Very, very orthodox. Script doesn't change. People don't want to change. But this I'm using for learners, for beginners, because my whole concern is the learner, and learner should be helped. This is the learner-friendly approach I'm trying, at least to read Konkani, it will be learner-friendly approach. Some people may accept. My friend, my student, Father Jason Pinto, he uses this one. He uses when he writes on WhatsApp. I use it consistently. Whenever I have to write Konkani, I use this now. But publications, no, they use the traditional. And if you read traditional, you don't know how to pronounce that word. Like chor and chor, they don't make a distinction. Then how to say chor or chor? Bore and bore. Maze and maze. The learner gets confused. But in this system, you know definitely how it should be pronounced, provided you learn it. Once you know the symbol, now for instance, this symbol for a. So once you know the symbol means a, you cannot pronounce this one as door or door. No, der. Der. Of course, I have not taught you the consonants, which I'll be teaching you tomorrow. Then you know each of the symbol has one pronunciation. This letter the, this is a, and this is r. So the r, like this. How children read, same way you can read.
Can we have Neil?
Yes.
Can we have Neil Lobo?
Beg yeah, pardon? Sure. Father, I'm Neil. Father, I just wanted to check with you. You said that if there's a single vowel in a word, then you have to prolong that word.
The vowel, correct.
But when you said Nath, for example, granddaughter, why did you not say Nath? I mean, why did you not pronounce the A? Prolong the A.
And yes, it is not Nath. You cannot say Nath. See, that prolongation is, what shall we say, varies. It is not Nath, not that short. Nath.
Okay.
Nath.
Okay. Nath. Got it, Father. Thank you.
Yeah. Slightly longer. It is not Nath. No. Not that exaggeration. No.
Okay.
Slightly longer.
Sure. Thank you, Father.
Yeah.
Catherine Mondal.
Good evening, Father.
Yeah. Don't say good evening, good morning. You please come straight to your
Okay. I'm totally new to this language, Konkani. So my question may be invalid, but since I'm very curious about it, I want to ask this. This B-A-Y, you said it is bai, right?
Yes.
But at the same time, B-A-N-Y, we have the nasal sound and we call it bai.
Bai, yeah.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, so if that is the case, then where it is K-H-O-N-T, we say khant, right?
Not khant, khant.
Khant, okay, khant. Okay, yes. And D-O-N-T is?
Beg pardon, what is it?
D-O-N-T.
Dant.
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 Yeah, dant. Okay, so the N sound, why we say N? Over there, B-A-N-Y, if we did not say bani, like, you know,
no,
so then why it is?
It cannot be bani because this Y, see, this is a consonant I have not taught you. So it is year.
Okay.
This Y sound is year.
Okay.
So when you will get the whole total picture, when I teach you vowels, we have finished. We are doing exercises and still there are many more exercises we have to do tomorrow. And then consonant, once we covered vowels and consonant, then you get the total picture. This letter Y, its pronunciation is Konkani, is only and one and only pronunciation here.
Okay.
So
okay,
it cannot be bani.
Okay.
It has to be bai.
Bai. So there we are not pronouncing the N word, N alphabet, right?
No, you don't pronounce it. This one nasalizing the, this one. You know how this is, you know, I would have written, I'm going to delete it. I would have written this way.
Yeah. No.
Sorry. One minute. Mm-mm. No, not this way. No, something is happening here. 1 minute. It could have been written with the another one, the teal, which now I am not getting. No, not that way. That is that using the teal I would have done. Forget about it.
Okay.
I'll practice tomorrow. This N is nasalizing this vowel A.
Okay.
So the B A N bang bang, and Y here bang.
Bang. Okay.
Bang.
Okay, Father. Okay, thank you, Father.
Yeah.
Can we have Sebastian D'Souza?
Hello, Father. Actually, my grandmother has some different pronunciations. Like for Gar, she calls it as Gor, and for As, she calls it as Eyes. So I just want to know which is the, you know, the.
Yeah. Now, for example, Gar. Let me come to your first example, Gar. It is the Catholics in Goa. Due to the Roman script was changed when the missionaries, I showed you the dictionary here of this missionaries, they write a, there is a symbol for a.
Okay.
The Jesuit missionaries, the Franciscan missionaries who came from Europe, they learned the language here and they wrote these dictionaries or these grammars, they use a symbol. It is when Konkani was banned here in Goa, Konkani was given up and Portuguese was taken up. And the common people who revived this language in Pune, in Bombay, they used the typewriter. And they didn't have the symbol A. So they used O. So that become Ghor. G-H-O-R, they made Ghor. Hindus don't say Ghor. They say Ghar.
Yeah.
So it is only the Catholics who do not know any other script. They say Ghor. Your grandmother probably, I would say it's not wrong, it is a dialectal. I told you very beginning, I am teaching you standard pronunciation, and the same pronunciation is used in Devanagari, same standard pronunciation used in Kannada script. Kannada script people, they don't say Ghor. Even they laugh at it, it's Konkani. They say, what is Ghor? They say Ghar. Same way Nagari. Therefore, the Hindus in Goa laugh at the Catholics. And they ask me, how do you know Konkani? I say, why not? It's my mother tongue. And I correct them, their mistakes. It's not that they don't do mistakes. They make mistakes. So that's one. Then you said that word as. I use the word as, and there is another word A-I-Z, eyes.
Yeah.
Both are there. Both are there. I prefer the form because of the old Cochrane dictionary. Based on that, I chose A-Z, as.
All right.
Eyes is not wrong. See, I'm not telling you it is wrong. It is dialectal. When it is wrong, I'll tell you. There is difference between dialectal pronunciation and wrong pronunciation. Now, for instance, if you say bani, bani, it is a wrong pronunciation. But if you say, okay, everybody say bani in Konkani. So that, no. Now you say this one, this word you take, dar. Those, they write D-O-R and they say door.
Yeah.
Door. Then I say it is a dialectal pronunciation. Because in Konkani we have dar, we have door, we have door. Three different words, three different meanings. So with this system, there is no doubt at all. One pronunciation, one meaning. Finished.
Okay, thank you so much, Father.
No, nothing to thank. It is my duty to teach.
Can we have Sushil Pal?
Sir, my doubt has been cleared.
Go.
Sorry?
My doubt has been cleared in last two.
Okay, fine. Can we have Cassie Dias?
Hi, Father. So my question is with regards to the nasal vowels. So anything that ends with N or M after an English standard vowel, that's when you add the nasal vowel, or is this assumption wrong?
See, I said nasalization, we use basically three symbols. One is N here. Mm-hmm. When do we use this initial position? Initial position or middle. Here it is in the middle position because this is the and it's the middle. This is in the middle position. Here also it is in the middle position. We use N and we use M at the end of the word. See, the dash AM means end of the word. This is the convention. See here, param. This M, it is not param. Para. See how I am reading syllable by syllable. Let me repeat. Pa, ra, and with this ra, para.
Okay.
And at the end, I said for going. See here, we use nasalization. This is to be. This is going. I could have written G O N Y, but then you know. People may not accept. They say you have corrupted our holy name. So I didn't want to irritate them. So I said, let it be. This is correct pronunciation. Going.
Okay. Yeah, it's more clearer now.
Only thank in you. This place I made an exception. Otherwise, I should have written G-O-N-Y. Because it is a proper noun. Being a proper noun, I said, let it be. To accept this itself, it took years in Goa for me to convince are people in Konkani Roman script, and finally they accepted after hurting them a lot. Freddy, all he knows all this history of it. But we will not get into that controversy. Our job is to learn a new language, which is quite tough. Yeah.
Thank you.
Do we have anybody else who wants to ask any doubt? There's a question. What are some of the biggest differences we might encounter between this script and the other Roman scripts?
The traditional, you can read that traditional Roman script. It is not that these two are two totally different. No. For instance, you take this word by. They will write B-A-I. Okay? I've written B-A-Y. For this word you take, Nath. Same. Traditional system and this system, same. Nath. or nant, you take nant, same, or you take para, no difference between the traditional system and mine, and para, same, or sheik and shink, same, tea and teen, same, no difference. The difference comes here. I use this symbol for a, this symbol for closed O, and this is for O. Here is the one in Konkani Roman script, they use only one symbol, letter O, and you don't know when to say a, when to say O, and when to say O. And in this system, you know this is O, this is O, and this is a. There are few differences are there. Then I maybe at the end of the course I might give you the traditional writing system.
Can we have Deborah Miranda?
Yeah. Is it possible for us to access the file so we can revise it before the next class?
Beg pardon?
Yeah. I'll take the files from father and we'll upload it, and then the link will be sent to you.
Okay, thank you.
Savio, if you can give it to Frederick, sharing through WhatsApp is easier because our mail gets overloaded with the access to the drive.
Not exactly through mail. We may share it with like on WhatsApp only, but the link, because these files may be a little bit heavier also, and sharing it to all the participants will be a little difficult.
Okay, but share it on the Google Drive.
No, we have our own website. We'll be uploading it there. Okay. And the link will be sent to you all.
Okay. Thank you.
Father, there's one question. What is the correct pronunciation of the capital of Goa? Panjim or Panaji?
See, now the names of most of the Goan cities and villages, there is utter confusion. There is one native word, then the Portuguese-sized pronunciation, and the another one, the visitors or the tourists when they come. Actually, it is Panji. Konkani, we say Panji. But the Portuguese Panji, and English become Panaji or Panjim. English become Panjim, and Panaji came from Marathi, Panaji. It is Konkani, we people say Panji. O Gaon Kancho, Panji. O Madgaon, Mapsa, Miramar. Miramar is not a problem. But as you said, that Panjim is Anglo-sized, Panji is Portuguese-sized, Panaji Marathi-sized, and Panji is Konkani.
What about Ponje?
Ponje means at Panji. Aao Ponje rahta, aao Ponje veta. Punya gaonche naav kite Ponje na Panji.
Okay, father. I think we are almost done. We just have 2 minutes for it. Shall we wind up, like, if we don't have any other questions?
Sure.
I don't think we have anybody else asking
a
any
good question from students. Help the teacher to become a better teacher.
True, father.
Yes. And a good student, a good teacher helps student to become a better student. So I try my best to help you to become a better student. Practically all the words I given the meaning for you here in this chart, so they are very clear to you. So you not worry about what is the meaning of this word. All the words which I'm using here, the English meaning is provided to you, provided you know that in English.
What is the correct pronunciation of Naveli or Navelim?
Naveli, but how Navele Veta? Naveli. Naveli.
Okay. I think Father will wind it up now.
Yeah.
We have already.
Yes. Yeah. And we say Dev Bare Karu, that means thank you. And Dev Bari Radyu, that means good night, because here in Miramar it is already 8 o'clock and it is night. Maybe where other parts of the world it may be a day or noon, I don't know. Therefore I said Dev Bari Radyu. We will meet tomorrow, and tomorrow when we start the class, I will ask for clarification. You have any other doubts? If you have, I will clarify those doubts, and then I continue with the further lessons. We have no syllabus to complete, but still we have to cover quite a few structures, otherwise you won't be able to learn Konkani. So maybe first 5 minutes I will give for clarification, and then I continue with my presentation. Thank you and see you tomorrow.